वेलकम टू अनिता ऑनलाइन क्लासेस क्लास 10th सब्जेक्ट साइंस अंडर चैप्टर 6 लाइव प्रोसेसेस टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू टॉक अबाउट फोटोसिंथेसिस दैट इज वी आर गोइंग टू टॉक अबाउट द न्यूट्रिशन इन ग्रीन प्लांट्स. फोटोसिंथेसिस इज द प्रोसेस बाय विच ग्रीन प्लांट्स दैट इज ऑटोट्रॉफ्स मेक देयर ओन फूड बाय यूजिंग वॉटर फ्रॉम सॉइल एंड कार्बन डाइऑक्साइड फ्रॉम एयर इन प्रेजेंस ऑफ क्लोरोफिल एंड सनलाइट. यू आर वेरी फेमिलियर विद दिस डेफिनेशन. वॉट दिस डेफिनेशन टेल अस दैट ग्रीन प्लांट्स विच आर हैविंग क्लोरोफिल इन दैम दे ट्रैप सनलाइट दैट इज एनर्जी ऑफ सन सोलर एनर्जी दे ट्रैप सोलर एनर्जी एंड इन प्रेजेंस ऑफ सनलाइट एंड क्लोरोफिल they can make their own food by using carbon dioxide and water as raw materials. Carbon dioxide they take from air and water they take from soil. And they make their food in the form of glucose and oxygen is released as byproduct. You can note down one thing here. That all the things which are necessary for this process are carbon dioxide, water, sunlight and chlorophyll. It means without carbon dioxide, water, sunlight and chlorophyll, photosynthesis cannot take place. So now with the help of some experiments, we are going to prove that these four things, carbon dioxide, water, sunlight and chlorophyll are essential for the process of photosynthesis. So children, here we are going to talk about our first experiment to prove that sunlight is necessary for the process of photosynthesis. Before we start this experiment, let me tell you one fact. We have discussed the definition of photosynthesis in which I had told you that green plants make food by the process of photosynthesis. And this food is in the form of glucose. This glucose is used by plant to perform various activities like respiration, transportation, reproduction. Many activities are there that a plant has to perform, has to do for living. So it creates or it generates energy by burning glucose for doing all these processes. Now the glucose which is formed by the process of photosynthesis, the whole amount of glucose cannot be used then and there. There will be some extra amount of glucose which is left after utilizing for various activities. So that extra amount of glucose is stored in plant in its various parts in the form of starch. So we can say extra glucose is stored in the form of starch. Okay. So now is this thing clear to you? Now you will be able to understand this experiment. For this experiment, we take a potted plant. And we keep this plant for 3-4 days in complete darkness. Do you know why do we do that? When we put it in complete darkness, that means no photosynthesis is taking place for 3-4 days. That also means that the whole amount of starch which was stored in plant, in this plant, is utilized by the plant to produce energy for doing various functions. And no new glucose is formed. So now the parts, all the parts of this plant are without starch. They do not have any starch in them. And no new glucose is formed. Now after 3-4 days, yes, one more thing. We are keeping this plant away from sunlight, but we are watering it regularly. Okay. We have not to let the plant die. Now we put this plant again. Now before putting the plant into sunshine, we do one thing that we choose any one leaf of this plant and a small central part of this leaf. We cover with aluminium foil. We take a piece of aluminium foil and the central part of a leaf. We cover it with aluminium foil. And children, this aluminium foil should cover the upper, the lower and both the sides. Upper part, lower part and both the sides of leaf completely for that particular part. We are taking this much of part only. This particular part must be completely covered with aluminium foil or black paper. Its upper side, its lower side and sides. That means this part should not get any sunlight at all. Rest of the part are exposed to sunlight. So we can say here is a leaf in this plant, a small portion of which is not getting sunlight and rest of the part is getting this enough amount of light, will get enough amount of light when we put this pot into bright sunshine. So now after making all this arrangement, we will take this potted plant from darkness to the bright sunlight. Okay, now we will keep this plant for 3-4 days. We will put it into bright sunshine. When we put it into the bright sunshine, that means all the green plants which are exposed to sunlight will photosynthesize. They will make glucose and that glucose, if it is extra, will be stored in the form of starch. It means this leaf is having starch into it and this leaf also should have starch into it. Okay. After 3-4 days, we pluck this leaf out. After plucking it, we remove its aluminium foil. And now, we put it into warm water for some time. When we put this leaf into warm water for some time, then its plasma membrane or we can say cellular membrane, its cell membrane, they break down. By this process, it will become easier to allow the iodine to enter into the cells later when we will perform the iodine test. Is it clear? What we did? We plucked the leaf from the plant and put it into warm water for some time so that the cell membranes can break down and later when we will perform the iodine test, the iodine will be permitted or this leaf will become more permeable to iodine. More permeable means it will allow the iodine to enter its cells easily. Got it? Now after making it permeable for iodine by putting it into warm water, we do another thing, that is removal of chlorophyll. Now we are going to remove the chlorophyll of the leaf so that it will serve two purposes. First thing, that iodine test will be clearly visible and second thing that after removal of this chlorophyll, we will not be able to recognize that which part is having chlorophyll and which is not having chlorophyll. The whole leaf is same for us. Now, what we do? We remove chlorophyll. How do we remove chlorophyll? We take a big beaker. In this big beaker, we have filled water. This water is being heated with the help of a burner. This way, this big beaker is serving as water bath. Now, we take a small beaker and into this beaker, we take alcohol. Now, when this beaker is kept into this heating water, then the alcohol will also be heated up. Now this indirect heating of a solution by putting it into another solution, this arrangement is called water bath. Okay. Now we heat it. See, one more question may arise in your mind, that why do we not heat this beaker directly in which alcohol is there? We can, why can't we heat the beaker directly in which alcohol is there for decolorization, then children, I would like to tell you that if we heat the beaker directly, which is having, which is containing alcohol in it, then alcohol can catch fire. So it is not safe. So now we heat water. In turn, alcohol is heated up, and this leaf starts to give out its chlorophyll. And as a result, after some period of time, it is heated until all the chlorophyll is removed. The leaf becomes decolorized and the alcohol becomes green because now chlorophyll is dissolved into it. Now we take it out. We take out the leaf and wash it with water so that it may become soft. And also, if any small amount of chlorophyll is left over there, that can also be removed. After doing so, we put this decolorized leaf into a petri plate and we pour iodine drop by drop with the help of a dropper on this leaf. Now this leaf, which is decolorized leaf, on that we are pouring the iodine solution drop by drop. Iodine solution is yellowish brown solution. Okay, so as we pour the drops, you will notice that the leaf becomes blue black in color, but you will also notice that the part which was covered by aluminum foil or black paper is not turning blue black in color. What does it show? That the part that had received sunlight, that had been exposed to sunlight, those parts have become blue black, whereas the part which was not exposed to sunlight have not become blue black. Why has it happened? See children, this test is known as a starch test. And what is a starch test? That whenever iodine, a few drops of iodine are dropped on a substance containing starch, then the starch present in that substance turns blue black. Okay, so the same is happening here. These parts received sunlight or they were exposed to sunlight, so they become blue black because they are having starch, and the part which was not exposed to sunlight did not have starch, so it remains colorless. So this is all about this experiment. By this experiment we can prove that sunlight is necessary for the process of photosynthesis. Now we are taking the second experiment to prove that carbon dioxide is essential for the process of photosynthesis. For this again we take a potted plant, and this time we take a bottle, wide mouth bottle. In this bottle we take KOH solution, that is potassium hydroxide solution. The potassium hydroxide solution has a property of absorbing carbon dioxide. KOH solution can absorb carbon dioxide gas present in air. So we take a potted plant and there is a wide mouth bottle. In this bottle there is KOH solution. Now what we do, we take a cork with one hole into it. In this hole we fix the leaf in such a way that half the portion of leaf remains inside the bottle and rest of the half remains outside the bottle. The portion which is inside the bottle, this portion is getting light because the bottle is transparent. Chlorophyll is there and this leaf is connected to the soil of pot, so it is getting water also. So this portion of leaf is getting water, sunlight and chlorophyll it already has. Now when we introduce this leaf, when we fix this leaf this way inside the bottle, then some air is present around the leaf in this air there will be carbon dioxide gas also. So that means carbon dioxide gas is also available to this portion? No, carbon dioxide gas is not available to this portion, because this carbon dioxide gas is absorbed by this KOH solution. So now what is the conclusion of this description? That this part of leaf which is inside the bottle is having chlorophyll, it is getting water, it is getting sunlight also, but it is not getting carbon dioxide only. And one more thing, before we start this experiment, as we had done in case of first experiment, that we put this potted plant into darkness for 3-4 days so that the leaf is completely de-starched. D means absent. De-starched means the starch is absent. So first of all, we put the potted plant in darkness for 3-4 days, by which the whole starch will be removed and no new glucose is formed. Now we bring this potted plant into sunlight and we make this arrangement. Before bringing it to sunlight, we made this arrangement that one of the leaf is introduced into a bottle with KOH solution. Now when we put it in sunlight, then as I told you earlier, this part of leaf is getting what? Sunlight, then water and chlorophyll it contains itself. And carbon dioxide which was present around this leaf in this bottle is already absorbed by KOH solution. So now this part of leaf is not getting carbon dioxide only. Now we put this arrangement for 3-4 days in bright sunlight, and that means the photosynthesis is taking place, and as a result glucose should have formed into all the green part or the all the green parts of the plant. After 3-4 days we pluck this leaf. Again, what is the second step? Before performing the iodine test, what should we do? We should take this, we should pluck this leaf and put it into warm water for some time so that the cell membranes may break down and it becomes soft enough to allow the iodine solution to enter into the cells. And after that, what is the next step? That we boil this leaf into alcohol in water bath arrangement, where in a big beaker there is water and in a small beaker there is alcohol. The big beaker is heated up directly on the burner and the alcohol gets heated up by coming in contact with this hot water. And we continue heating alcohol this way in water bath, and the leaf present in it, it gets decolorized. So we heat it until the whole amount of chlorophyll is removed, the leaf is decolorized and alcohol becomes green in color. Now we take this decolorized leaf and put it into a petri plate. Then we pour iodine solution on this leaf drop by drop. What we observe, the part of leaf that was out of the bottle turns blue black, whereas the part of leaf that was inside has no change into it. So what does it show? I have told you this test is called starch test, and when iodine solution comes in contact with the starch turns blue black in color. But here you can see this part, that means this part is having starch and this part is not having starch. This part is having starch because it had performed photosynthesis. In this part the glucose was formed and the extra glucose was stored in the form of starch. In case of this part, no photosynthesis took place, no glucose formed, so there is no starch. So what is proved by this experiment? That yes, carbon dioxide is essential for photosynthesis, because in case of this part of leaf, everything was available. Out of four conditions, three conditions were available, that is sunlight, water and chlorophyll. Still photosynthesis could not take place because the fourth condition, that is carbon dioxide was not available to this part of tree. So I think it is clear that carbon dioxide is essential for photosynthesis. So now we are going to perform another experiment to prove that chlorophyll is necessary for photosynthesis. For that we take a potted plant in which there are variegated leaves. Variegated leaves means this type of plants have leaves, the parts of which are green in color and the parts of which are not green in color, or we can say they are white or yellowish in color. So the parts which are green, only they have chlorophyll and rest of the parts do not have chlorophyll. So in the same leaf, some parts are green and some are non-green. One example of such plant is croton. So say we take a potted plant of croton and it has variegated leaves, some portion with chlorophyll, some portion without chlorophyll. Now again, like other experiments, we will put this potted plant for a few days, 2-3-4 days into darkness so that the leaf may become de-starched. We have already discussed in detail why do we need to de-starch the leaf. After that we put this arrangement again in bright sunshine so that photosynthesis can take place, glucose can be synthesized and extra glucose can be stored in the form of starch. After that we pluck out one leaf, put it in warm water so that the cell membranes can break down and the cells become more permeable to iodine solution. After that the next step is boiling this variegated leaf in alcohol in water bath arrangement. After that this leaf will become colorless, or it is decolorized, all the chlorophyll is removed. Now here we have this leaf. In this leaf we cannot identify that which portion is green and which one is non-green. Now we put this leaf in a petri plate and we drop iodine, which is yellowish brown solution. We pour yellowish brown iodine solution on this leaf, which is decolorized drop by drop. What we observe, the parts of leaf which had chlorophyll, only those parts have become blue-black in color. Rest of the parts have no change. What does it show? This test is for detection of starch. So, if in presence of iodine solution, a part of a plant is turned blue-black in color, that means it is having starch into it. And where has this starch come from? Come into it? Because the photosynthesis had taken place. Glucose was formed and extra glucose is stored in the form of starch. And in other parts there is no starch because photosynthesis did not take place. Now come to this plant. In case of this plant, what is the condition? First thing, it is getting sunlight. Second thing, it is also getting carbon dioxide. And third thing, it is also getting water. Only the parts of leaf, some parts of leaf, they are not having chlorophyll in them. And in only those parts, only the starch could not be detected. So this shows that chlorophyll is also essential for photosynthesis. So with the help of experiments, we have proved that which things are essential for photosynthesis, and they are so much essential that if any one of them is missing, then photosynthesis cannot take place.